How to drive a car in reverse gear? There are basically two methods how to do it. Method number one, backing up in a straight line. A 360 degree check is when you actively turn your head and shoulders to look all around your vehicle in a complete circle. Make sure there is nothing in your way or moving toward you that you may need to take into account before backing up. Place your right foot on the brake. When driving forward or in reverse, your right foot should be the only one on the gas or brake pedal. If your car is equipped with a standard transmission, your left foot manages the clutch, but in vehicles with automatic transmissions, the left foot simply goes unused. Press your right foot on the brake pedal firmly so that the vehicle won't move once it is in reverse. Put your left hand on the top middle of the steering wheel. While it may be customary to drive with your hands at 10 and 2 o'clock on the steering wheel, backing up will require that you turn your body to the right. Place your left hand at the top of the wheel so you can easily make small adjustments to keep the vehicle moving straight as you back up. Put the vehicle in reverse. Depending on the transmission, your vehicle came equipped with there are a few ways you may need to shift into reverse. On automatic vehicles, it usually requires pressing a button on the shift lever and pulling it backward until it is aligned with the letter R. In standard vehicles equipped with a 5-speed transmission, you can usually shift into reverse by pressing the shift lever all the way to the left and pulling it backward. Look out the back of the car over your passenger side shoulder. Provided your view is not obstructed, twist your body to the passenger side so you can look out the back window of your vehicle over your right or passenger side shoulder. Make sure you do not remove your foot from the brake pedal. If you are driving a box truck or other vehicle that blocks your view out of the back window, you will have to rely on your side mirrors to guide you. Ease your right foot off the brake slowly. As you take the pressure off the brake pedal with your right foot, the vehicle will begin to move backward. Most vehicles' engines idle at a high enough revolutions per minute to propel the vehicle without any need to apply the gas. Keep your foot hovering over the brake pedal as you back up just in case you need to stop or slow down. Method number two, backing up using your mirrors. Check your mirrors before you begin. If you cannot see out the back of the vehicle, you will need to use side mirrors to see as you back up. Before you begin, adjust your side mirrors to ensure you can see the side of the vehicle, the ground, and anything coming up from behind you. Check each mirror frequently. Using mirrors will only show you what is behind your vehicle on either side, so it's important to check both sides often. This will prevent you from accidentally hitting something or from not noticing as someone approaches from one side or the other. Enlist the help of a friend. If you are backing up using only your mirrors in a difficult area, you may choose to ask a friend to guide you. Using your mirrors to keep an eye on a friend that is checking your clearances from the back may be your best option when driving a box truck or something else with a severely limited visibility.